Welcome to the Shemane Show, very creatively titled, I may add. If you love God, love this country, and want conservative news with a rock and roll twist, then you're in the right place. Take out your podcast app and type in The Shemane Show. It's S-H-E-M-A-N-E. And subscribe in the upper right-hand corner. Also, for a brand new platform, check out Podbean. It's P-O-D-B-E-A-N. And I'm going to be going live there. And why you might be interested in that, because I'm going to have some great guests from my husband, rock and roll musician Ted Nugent. Also, people like Scott Kesterson from Bards FN and The Kilted Christian, Juan O'Savin, Nino Rodriguez, and so many more. I'm super excited. Today, guys, I'm going to be talking about what it's like to be married to a rock star as I'm reflecting on Ted's recent tour. Also about Juan O'Savin, Scott Kesterson, and so much more. But before we get started, I wanted to tell you about the superfood nutrition that Ted and I have been taking for years that has really seriously changed our lives. We take them every day, and Ted attributes his energy at 73 years old. He attributes that energy to taking these products. Now, they're all natural. I've been in the fitness industry for more than 40 years, and I've seen a lot of products come and go, a lot of supplement companies, and I've tried just about all of them. And I have to tell you, I got to the point in my life where I honestly didn't know what I was going to do to get through the days. I was in so much pain. I started taking these products and it literally changed my life. I think they can change yours too. They're all natural supplements, bars, shakes, skincare products, and also sleep aids to help you with weight loss, energy, performance, sleep, and anti-aging, so much more. But we never go a day without these products. And if you're interested, they might work for you. I know they work for us. We will never go a day without them. If you're interested in finding out more, you can email me at wildlywell21@gmail.com. That's W-I-L-D-L-Y, wildlywell, W-E-L-L, 21@gmail.com. Hey, if you're in pain, you need energy, or you want to get in better shape, try these highly rated supplements that have natural, organic, and healthy products that I know work for me and work for Ted. And again, I've been around the block, so to speak, in the fitness industry. I've seen a lot of things come and go, and I won't go a day without these products. They work for us. They might work for you too. So email me at wildlywell21@gmail.com. And just in the email, write what you're interested in so we can help you get the products that you need. Again, weight loss, energy, performance, anti-aging, skincare, all of the above. So let me know and we'll get back with you soon. Okay, so we just finished Ted's tour. And I say we because, you know, it takes a village. It takes a lot of people to put on a tour. Of course, the amazing musicians, my husband, Ted, who I think is the best guitar player in the world. But yeah, of course, I'm biased. And incidentally, why isn't Ted in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, but Madonna is? Now, I have to, full disclaimer, when I was growing up, I listened to Madonna. I did. I liked to dance and but her political views are just the opposite. And it's interesting. It's almost as if, you know, come on, let's be honest. Madonna does not play rock and roll music. It's pretty much dance, disco, all of that. And it's just interesting. Why is she in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? Ha ha. Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and Ted isn't. Anyways. We've got Jason Heartless on the drums and Greg Smith on bass. The crew has, and so many people involved. It does seriously take a whole group of people, from the sound technician, the lighting director, the guitar tech, the drum tech, the bass tech. There's a road manager, an assistant road manager, a booking agent, bus driver and truck driver, and so many more. I'm the go-to person for backstage meet and greets, like when Ted, you know, we pull into a city, and it's just such a well-oiled machine. It's such a pleasure being a part of it. It's so neat to watch these people work so well together. And Ted's got a list of people he meets before the show, some celebrities and, you know, some military heroes and some people who just want to just say hi to Ted. So I help coordinate all that stuff. I also help with catering. What does Ted want before and after the show or during? And, you know, I don't really have a job title other than wife. I don't know. I think there should be something else. If you have any ideas, post them in the comment section. But, you know, tour life, travel, and I got to say, I've never seen, Ted and I have been married for 33 years, and I've never seen the fans so engaged. The audience is all, you know, I'll admit, over the years when Ted's very bold and brave and very outspoken, if you haven't noticed. And sometimes in the past, he said some things that I'm surprised I don't have a bruise on my forehead for all the times I've hit the heel of my hand to my forehead going, oh, why'd you have to say it like that? But these days, this tour that he just finished, I've never seen the crowd so engaged. And when he would say all these remarks that are very politically charged, very outspoken, the crowd goes nuts. It's the timing for this tour is just has never been better. He didn't tour for two years because of the pandemic. And it's almost like everybody needed desperately for this tour. And I had, it was Juan, actually. Juan and Scott Kesterson both said, you know, this could be the most important tour of Ted's life. And I think it really was, because Ted's always been outspoken. And to watch the crowd interact, and, you know, Ted's kind of a comedian up on stage, and very much obviously an entertainer. And the crowd is, I see the light bulbs going off. They get it. And they're so appreciative. And never before have we had so many military, federal marshals, military heroes, and red-blooded patriots who are ready to fight. I can see that they are so excited when Ted makes a comment about political events, things that are going on. And, you know, I think people are ready to fight spiritually for this country. I mentioned Juan O'Savin. He came to a concert recently, and I've been talking to him for a couple of years now about what's really going on in this country. And not only Juan, but a few other people have told me, you know, we're coming upon some really dark and difficult days. And that's not to say that we're trying to, and by sharing this with you, I'm not trying to make you fearful, but prepared. You know, before Ted goes on tour, he has to prepare mentally and physically and strategize with his manager, with the band, and there's so much preparation that's involved in planning, booking each concert, the venues, the travel, the gas, the food, the lodging, so much that goes on, rehearsing. And, you know, right now, we have to be prepared for some changes, I believe. And if you're thinking, man, things just keep getting crazier and crazier every day, you're not alone. From the FBI covering up Hunter Biden's laptop to the raid on President Trump's home. And that's what was just last week. Now, things are happening so fast at such an accelerated rate. I believe it's because that the other party knows the party's over and they just don't want to leave the house. They want to keep drinking, celebrating, having a good time. And they don't want you to find out how corrupt they are. They're hanging on to power by a thread. And like a sinking ship, they're going down and they're taking everything and everyone they can with them. You know, one of the biggest changes I see in the coming days, a lot of people have reached out and said, well, what can we do? What can we do? The biggest change and challenge that we're going to have is our mindset. we're going into, and we are in a spiritual war, and we need to be prepared. And this is a war unlike any other we've fought. I want to challenge you to start reading your Bible every day. Now, that doesn't mean you have to read for an hour or five. How about 5 minutes? Start somewhere. And if you've never prayed before, I recently spoke with somebody who said, you know, I don't know how to pray. And honestly, the way that I have started out, my prayer life has accelerated in the past couple of years when I went deep down the rabbit hole and found out some awful things about child trafficking, human trafficking, that I and seen some things, like the things on Hunter Biden's laptop that I can't unsee. And I don't always have the right words either. I'm not a Bible scholar, but I know that I'm coming from a place where I'm focusing on God. I'm putting God first. And I try to read the Bible every day. I'm not perfect at it, but I read the Bible with an open mind. And I say a little prayer before I read, asking for God to open my eyes and let me understand. Because sometimes I used to read the Bible when I was younger, much younger, and not even understand it. And a lot of times now, I'm going to be reading from the Tony Evans Bible Commentary. I want to read something to you in just a minute from there that really explains. I have about a dozen different Bibles, from the Founder's Bible that Scott Kesterson gave me to so many others that really explain a lot of what's going on and what I don't understand sometimes in the Bible. Since we've been talking about rock and roll tour, and I want to share with you some of the things that I see when Ted's on stage. He's got his guitar tech right near him, for example, and preparing different guitars, wiping down the guitar strings and the neck of the guitar because he sweats when he's playing. And the guitar tech tunes the guitar. There's a little monitor that gauges whether the strings are in tune or not, the guitar's in tune, and there's so many adjustments that have to be made. And sometimes you never know what's going to happen, so you just have to be prepared. You got to have the tools nearby, and you've got to be able to be ready for anything. Just the other day, it was funny because Tim, Ted's guitar tech, and I was standing right next to him watching him. And there are a handful of us who know, we've heard so many of Ted's shows, and we know, oh gosh, there is maybe a string out of tune or something out of tune. Or Ted, literally, Tim and I were looking at each other and talking to each other, and something happened. And all of a sudden we heard his guitar just slightly, nobody else, but a handful of us could tell, because we've heard so many of his concerts, that anything was out of tune at all in the least bit. And Ted, all of a sudden, he twisted something and tuned it in, and it was fine. And we still didn't know what happened until later on after the concert. Ted said that Ted's bass guitar player said, I accidentally bumped into Ted and it messed with his strings. So you have to be, even though Ted's been performing for 50 years, you got to be ready for anything. And I'm just using this analogy because, guys, what's going on in the world these days, we've got to be ready for anything. Nobody knows. You know, there are a lot of people who have specific dates in mind, and I don't follow that to a T. I have asked these people to tell me, okay, if you know anything that's coming up specifically, let me know so I can, you know, be prepared on that day, or I'm not going to travel or whatever it is. But the bottom line is that our most important communication needs to be with God so that we can be prepared for anything. And our wisdom and discernment comes from Him. And we are enlightened. The tools that we use are our Bible and our discretion, our discernment. And, you know, I feel lately like I'm just going where the Lord is taking me. I don't have as much. The other day, this tour, I got to tell you, it's very exhausting and I don't do anything. I'm not the one up there on stage playing the drums or playing the guitar or doing what the guys do in the crew. I mean, it's just an incredible amount of effort. I'm just going along, traveling almost every day, 7 days in a row, sometimes a different city. So it's not just the tour. Or it's not just the concert, but it's the travel. And then you're not sleeping in your own bed. You're eating food on the road and you know, things are a little bit messed up. So it's the other day we had a day off and we were at home and I was kind of feeling like a zombie, kind of feeling just exhausted. Plus we get in much later. And our dogs want to wake us. One night we got in at like 2:30 in the morning and the dogs are up at the crack of dawn. And I had like 4 hours of sleep and that's when I felt like a zombie. And I thought, you know what? I'm not going to put anything on my plate that I don't have to today. I like to work. I like to do things and I feel like I'm being called to do things like these podcasts and write books, which I have a new book coming out soon about toxic mold. If you want more information about that, go to killerhouse.org and you can hear about my story. But the other day I just said, you know what? I'm going where the Lord takes me today. I'm not going to put anything on my plate. I had an extra half an hour where I didn't have anything planned. And I just sat on my porch and I looked at the clouds in the sky. I just did nothing. And it's interesting how when you're doing those things, taking a shower, or gardening, or running, or working out, or exercising, you're doing things that don't require a lot of thinking. Isn't it interesting that that's when the thoughts come to you? That's when the good thoughts, the good stuff comes to you. So in order for us to be prepared, I think that the most important thing, like I said, is dealing with our mindset, not getting too stressed, avoiding things that make us worried. You know, there are certain things that we can't control, like traffic and people who push our buttons and things like that, the weather. But if we're prepared, if you bring an umbrella in your car, for example, then you're more prepared for when it rains. You know, so finding happiness where we can in those little things, those little moments, like if I just took 5 or 10 minutes to just go, okay, I'm just going to breathe. I just need to take a breathing break. I just need to relax for a minute and kind of recharge your batteries. And then you're better able to deal with that stress, to deal with the day-to-day stuff, to deal with those things that you see on TV that are just kind of freaking you out. But think about this. How stressful would it be if you found out that there was no electricity for a day, a week, or a month, or 2 months, and no running water or food? What can you do? Well, start preparing now. But you can also focus on your connection with God and don't allow yourself to get distracted by the other side's antics, which I know it's hard to do when they're taking our tax dollars and giving it to, let's pick something. Yes, let's pay off all the college loans. What about my college loan from 30 years ago? Are they going to pay that off too? No. How is that fair? Or let's give away our oil reserves. Or $80 billion to Ukraine or Afghanistan. You know, it's frustrating. It's frustrating to say the least, to sit back and watch our country being destroyed. But that's exactly what we cannot do. We can't sit back. We got to get involved in our local elections and writing letters to our representatives, to calling into radio shows when we hear something we don't agree with. You'd be surprised how many people you can wake up. I had the benefit of being around some people at Ted's concert recently, and they came to see Ted, obviously. But I happened to be in the backstage area, and this one woman came up. She was crying and shaking that I was there, and I'm looking, you know, over my right shoulder, looked over my left shoulder. I'm like, who, me? Like, really, I really feel like such an unlikely messenger. I'm happy to be in this in this position that I'm in because I feel like God put me here for a reason. And if that's to wake people up, then I feel blessed. But the most important thing is you've got to take care of your health. And you've got to take care of your mindset so that we can continue to do God's good work. I want to read to you from Tony Evans' Bible commentary. So this is Ephesians. This is the commentary for Ephesians 6:10 through 6:13. Humanity's true struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against evil spiritual forces in heaven. What we call spiritual warfare is the conflict in the spiritual realm that affects the physical realm. The daily problems we face here are rooted there. But importantly, the resources you need to fight the battle are there too. Paul told the Ephesians that through Christ, God has given them every blessing they need in heavenly places. That is the spiritual realm. The risen Christ is there at God's right hand, and Christians are spiritually there with him. But the cosmic powers of this darkness are also in the spiritual realm. The battle, Tony Evans says in his book, The Bible Commentary, the battle Christians face every day is rooted in the schemes of the devil, in his efforts to deceive us. He's happy for you to picture him as a cartoon character wearing a red jumpsuit with horns and carrying a pitchfork so that you won't take him seriously. Meanwhile, like an opposing football team, his demonic realm watches your game film. They know your history, they know your weak spots, and your sin patterns. Their goal is to keep you from experiencing God's will for your life. You're not their first assignment. They're good at what they do. You then have to fight the spiritual with the spiritual. Your human strength won't work. Your only hope is to be strengthened by the Lord and to put on the full armor of God. And so this, it says, the full armor is standing with truth, like the belt around your waist. You also need righteousness, like an armor on your chest. You need your feet sandaled with readiness in the gospel of peace. You need the shield of faith to extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. And of course, you need the helmet of salvation. And the last piece of armor is the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And they also add another one, which is prayer. Prayer changes everything. Guys, put on that full armor every day, every day, every day, all day, and especially at night. This is an incredibly monumental time that we're living in. It's actually kind of exciting, but of course, it is a little scary too. But you know, things are less scary and worrisome when you're prepared. Prepare for the worst, but with faith, you can expect the best outcome because we know, spoiler alert, we know that in the end, God wins. All right, everybody, thanks so much for listening. I appreciate each and every one of you. I love each and every one of you. Don't forget, email me at wildlywell21@gmail.com if you want to get the superfood supplements and nutrition that Ted and I take. I mean, if you're going to go out and get some food storage, this is the best thing. I've got so much of this. We're not going to go hungry. But leave me a brief message when you email me at wildlywell21@gmail.com and tell me what your concerns are, because there's different supplements and different plans for energy, weight loss, anti-aging, skincare, and we'll help you get started to feeling better than ever because you need to put on that full armor. You need to stand strong and feel better so that you can continue to fight this good fight for God. Thanks for listening, everybody. Please like and share. We have new shows every Tuesday and Thursday. And don't forget, I'm also on Podbean, P-O-D-B-E-A-N. P-O-D-B-E-A-N. It's a new platform that I only recently discovered, but the great thing is they're going to allow me to go live with these audio podcasts. And I love being able to see, I've been watching Scott Kester, or listening to Scott Kesterson at Bards FM. If you go to Podbean and check out Bards of War, B-A-R-D-S, Bards of War, and also The Kilted Christian. They both have amazing shows. I get so much information from them. Scott has 18 shows a week. I mean, it's incredible. But they go live, and I love being able to text back and forth with not only them, but also other people who are listening, other patriots who are listening to the show as well. It's a great, it feels like family, you know? So check it out, Podbean. I'm also on social media, the social media that I still have, Instagram and Facebook, look for the blue check, and also YouTube, Rumble, Truth Social, and Telegram. I'm scattered. I'm a little bit scattered. I'm here, there, and everywhere, and I post different things on different platforms, so check them out. You can also get my book, 4 Minutes to Happy, on Amazon or barnesandnoble.com. I've got a new book coming out, hopefully by the end of the year, on toxic mold. And you know, guys, I think that's why I'm here right now. I got sick and almost died from toxic mold exposure in my home that was once featured on MTV Cribs. I couldn't walk up a flight of stairs if my life depended on it, and I had to become my own investigative sleuth because doctors couldn't help me. I felt like I was dying. I had 4 different types of mold in my bloodstream and also pre-emphysema and debilitating migraines that I was hospitalized for. And, you know, when no doctors can help you, and for me, I started watching Ted get sick and my son Rocco get sick, and I had to fight. I had to fight for myself and I had to fight for them. And I think that's why I'm here. I got that fighter instinct. And when I see something that nobody else can help me with, I start to investigate it for myself. So if you're in that place too, you're in the right place now. Thanks for listening, everybody. I'll talk to you next time. Have a great rest of your day.